This video is brought to you by LG UltraWide.
Check this out, guys. Check this out.
It's here.
That's World of Warcraft. That's not what it's supposed to say.
Oh!
Check that out, guys. This is the biggest monitor that I've ever seen, period. 49-inch quad HD display. That is crazy. Wait. You gotta keep it clean. This monitor is like a little baby. You gotta take care of it. Very important.
Look at that.
That is just crazy, guys. Damn! Now this is an amazing experience, guys. If you edit on this thing in Premiere, look at this timeline. Look at the space you have. Look at all the panels, all the windows that you can fit on this thing. It's amazing.
Is there a reflection in this thing? Let me just...
There we go, that is much better. Now, Windows or Mac will see your display as one, so that means that you can maximize your program to cover up the entire screen, and if you do wish to use it as a dual monitor, you can simply enable that through the menus in here. You can also work with two programs then without having that bezel in the middle. Jannik is not getting this one. He already has two LG monitors. This one is coming to me. This one is going on my desk. You hear that, Jannik? Now, first of all, a big thanks here to LG for sponsoring us today again. And guys, if you stay till the end, I'm gonna have a very special surprise for all of you. And yes, it involves this monitor right here. Now, to launch this product, a 3D artist by the name of Alessio De Vecchi, if I pronounce his name right, created a promotional video about this monitor. You know, let's just have a look at it. That was really cool. If you want to see more of Alessio's work, then check out his Instagram. It's pretty amazing what that guy can do. Now, initially, LG asked us to make a video where we break down the commercial and teach you guys how it was created in a copycat video. But I have no experience in 3D whatsoever. I've never opened a 3D program in my life. However, I wanted to learn it. I just don't have any idea where to start. So I thought, why not ask the creator of the promotional video itself?
Hey guys, I'm Alessio. I created that funny, hopefully funny video that you just saw up there.
That was amazing, Alessio.
Thank you for having me here.
No, thank you. I mean, could you share a tip to anyone who wants to start with 3D?
The first tip is do not become a 3D artist.
What?
Listen to your mom and study law. Yeah, I realized that if I really wanted to do this, meaning work and my personal projects, I should give up on social life and I should have just stayed in. However, guys, jokes aside, I think that a good point to start is Cinema 4D. Cinema 4D is a friendly tool. It has some limitations, but it's definitely like very good for beginners.
Yeah, that's true. I think most of us probably know Cinema 4D because it has a connection with Adobe After Effects, allowing you easily to go back and forward between the two programs. Essentially, what you create in Cinema 4D can be further manipulated as a layer inside Adobe After Effects. Now, I would also like to mention that Video Copilot has a very strong plugin for After Effects called Element 3D that allows you to create 3D models, textures, and animate them in a very easy environment. Maybe if Cinema 4D still kind of scares you, Element 3D could definitely be a great step in between. But Alessio, where did you learn all of this? I mean, definitely like the basics. Where did you start?
I transitioned from After Effects to Cinema 4D by following tutorials on Grayscale Gorilla. Grayscale Gorilla is still there, still a great website. There's a lot to learn. There's a lot of basic tutorials, especially the old ones. Nick will guide you through the basics of Cinema 4D. That's definitely the entry point.
Thanks for that resource. I'll leave a link to that website in the description below. And what would you say comes like after Cinema 4D?
Once you get the gist of it and you really want to be scared, then you can start using Houdini. I've been using Houdini for a little over a year now, maybe something more than that. and I still have no idea how it works. You look at it and you're like, what is this? Sometimes I even have trouble saving and exporting files. However, yeah, Houdini is very scary.
Okay, let's stay off the scary stuff for now then. Now, one thing that I always find hard is physics.
Yeah, man, like, you know, get your coffee ready, like have it on your table. I mean, don't spill it like me on the keyboard. However, yeah, you're gonna be up quite a long time trying to figure out why things don't work, but you know, that's also the beauty of 3D, I would think.
That's true. Now, I don't have much experience with 3D myself, but for 2D animations or anything with After Effects, I try to look around to see how physics work. Like, if you're on the bus, maybe don't sit on your phone, but just look outside. You know, how do people walk? How do the trees move through the wind? Or how do cars drive and accelerate? I think the world around you is still the best resource to understand physics. In a video that we're still working on, I also explained that you could use a real-world event as a template for your animations. A simple example is to throw a ball and film it, then steal that movement to animate your own 2D elements.
When you start using Cinema 4D, you know, probably you will end up making spheres. That's what everybody does. So tons of spheres, like you'll do like spheres everything. Also, you know, it's a good way to test dynamics.
Alessio, where could you get inspiration from?
Inspiration is not something that you just have for the most part, but it's also something that you train. You know, the more you work at it, the more you produce pieces like you as a personal work, and you know, the less the white canvas becomes scary. When you do a lot of 3D work and your head is always at it, it might happen that you dream, you have like dreams about 3D or dreams about things that you might want to do. I mean, at least that happens to me, but maybe, well, I have a problem there. So I have a little notebook next to my bed.
That's a good one. You know, I actually have a little notebook in the toilet. Now, I refuse to take my phone with me as that forces me to think about something else. And usually this gives me some kind of a space for new ideas, and I write down those things in my notebook.
I just sometimes wake up and I write down my ideas. Could be dreams or nightmares, and that's it. Then I go back to sleep. That's probably why my sleep quality is horrible.
Yep, I get that. You know, 3 a.m. and my brain decides to spin around for no reason. I think that many creatives suffer from that. Anyways, do you have a last tip for those who really want to turn 3D art or basically any form of creation into their job?
As for personal work, of course, you're going to get attached to what you do. Probably you're going to hate it once it's done. So the important thing is do not get attached to your commercial work because the client is going to destroy it anyway. So, for example, you spend times creating this very stylized character. It's super cool. Like, you love it. You give it TLC. And then the client is like, oh, why don't we use a stick figure?
Exactly. Now, before I did YouTube, I used to make commercials and corporate videos, and my number one stress factor was exactly that. And now my number one stress factor is to see how many views and likes we get in a video. Not sure if that's any better. Anyways, Alessio, I'm very curious. What kind of programs did you use to create that LG promo and why?
The video that you just saw was realized by using, I would say, 5 software, and I used Cinema 4D to design the main environment. And Cinema 4D is a great tool to crank out quick designs. Then I simulated the crowd with Houdini. I re-imported Cinema 4D, I did my lighting and shading. I composited in After Effects, color graded in Premiere. I know you shouldn't do that, it's not great. Finally, I used Audition to do the score. Yeah, that's it.
And there we thought we could do it all inside Premiere. Well, thank you so much for sharing your experience, Alessio. I'm gonna head over now to grayscalegorilla.com and see how we can make some spheres inside Cinema 4D.
Thank you, Jordi, for having me, and thank you guys for watching. I think Jordi told me to say, stay creative.
No, Alessio, you read the script wrong. You're supposed to interrupt me on the end and then steal that sentence from... Never mind. Oh yeah, thanks for sending me those bloopers of your video as well. I made a nice compilation of that. So those were the 5 tips from Alessio to start with 3D. But now, and that's probably why you're still watching, LG is giving away one of these beautiful beast monitors right here. That's right, this monitor could be in your hands. Now everyone can join, it's worldwide, and this is what you have to do. Make something creative, and this could be a short video or even a photo. It doesn't even have to be 3D. But inspire yourself with the tips from Alessio and upload your work to Instagram. Now, submissions start as of today, the 28th of May, until the 10th of June. Now, very important is gonna be that you use these three hashtags right here. And this way, LG can find your work and you're also in the running to win this monitor. And we will also be checking out the submissions and will regularly feature someone on our Instagram as well. So, more than enough reasons to participate. Now, you can find all the info in the description below together with our Instagram post as well. Of course, we are not eligible to win this monitor. Unfortunately, I would have liked two of them. But anyways, I wish everyone the best. I think this is a very good way to share some creativity around, and I'm very curious to see what you guys are gonna post. Thank you all so much for watching, and as always,
stay creative. Bye.
You see, now your intonation is not right.
I don't want to do this.
Smile, man, smile.
And it was like an interview. The video that you just saw that I made for the LG monitor. No, I don't like it.